Happy Halloween, everyone. Though I'm recording the actual voice over here on November 4th, the video footage you see here was taken on Halloween.
Your car is the shit. So hot.
Thank you. The trick of the matter is that at the time I did not realize that my microphone had actually completely broken. But this led to good things because now I've actually... Oh yeah, see what a good handler this is. I've actually gotten myself a Yeti. That's right, I've got a Yeti Blackout Edition, a real microphone for a change. So we'll see if this has any effect on things. I chose this car, the Frankenstange, because it is a very close analogy to the Sanctus. They're both Halloween-based machines. They're both way more expensive than they should be, really. They're both mostly about the looks. They both have good acceleration. And,
hey,
I like this one.
Listen, oh, Lester. I'm working on something interesting, I think, but I need a little time. Anyway, I got a request through the ether, so to speak. Someone's looking for a crew to take a score, but I don't know anymore. I thought maybe you'd be interested. Personally, I wouldn't touch it with a 10-foot barge pole because I don't know any of these people. But if you're interested, be my guest. I can tell them to come see you.
You know, the whole reason I did the Flika job was so he would stop calling me. Do you have to do all of them to get that to happen? So, for any rate, here, for those of you who don't know, the Sanctus is a bike that costs $2 million, roughly, about 5K short of 2 million. Accelerates very nicely to straight line and struggles going around curves. But it looks completely whack. I think we can call a picture up, throw that up here, perhaps. If I don't remember to do that, then just forgive me here. You can Google it. You can see that I'm leading myself to an editing error there somehow. But at any rate, you can imagine me just as easily spinning around and doing all kinds of stuff with the Sanctus here. But hey, we're soaking in that Halloween theme is the main deal here. We're Halloweening it up. Now this is a sports classic, so it's very hard to get a race going. Certainly not a stunt race, you know, loaded with sports classics. You just don't see it very often. It's a very tough car. And it looks great. I mean, this looks just like the Munster coach and all that, you know. And I do like my Frankenstanges.
Somebody help me.
I'm just pulling into my garage, sweetheart. Calm down. That's just... like a maniac, but... So here you can see, here we are in the holiday special car garage. We've got another Frankenstange. That's actually a little bit more... revved up. I think that's got full mods put to it. Then you've got this, the Lurcher. Now the Lurcher, that's a muscle car. And that means that we have a chance of getting it on the track. And that would be what we're going to try and do next. Can we get a race, or even a few races, with the Lurcher just to celebrate Halloween? That's what I want to do here. The Lost in the Damned looks interesting, but on the other hand, it also looks like every other adversary mode I play where I get shot in the head repeatedly and don't make a lot of money. So, I'm not saying that, you know, your results would be the same. You just gotta know yourself, you know? By the way, if you like drifting, this is your car. And it is available during the Halloween season for a little bit. Interestingly, if you buy it once, you can have it pretty much forever. And I can have this one pretty much stuck here forever. So it's probably time to start up the track. There we go. And at the time, I mean, when I bought my three Halloween cards, I thought, I'm never going to see these again. And I actually got, you know, pushed into... buying a shark card bought the three cars. And again, performance-wise, I mean, you know, the Lurcher's not bad. It's a little bit slippy, but not nearly as slippy as the Frankenstein. But again, that's a car you get for looks. There's so many of them that are just, you know, for looks. Tornado Rat Rod, hate to break it to you. It's a better performer than the Frankenstein, but not by much. Not a super fast car. If you have to race a Frankenstein, you're okay with that, but don't try and take a Sterling GT, you know, with the Tornado Rat Rod. Hey, we've got El Manana. Alright, I can take a duel on Trench 2. That'll work. Level 58. Looking like she's right out of 1958. That's an interesting look. Oh, better with the racing gear on. There you go. Let's go with the Lurcher. There we go. Ready to play. And there's our adversary. Oh, she's gone back old school. So this is... If she's not on a bike, why not be comfortable? That makes perfect sense. El Manana. Or no, it's El Manana. It's Eh Manana. Eh Manana? No. Tomaj. Dumani. There you go. It's just... Eh Manana. Pro racer. Eventually the job will launch. I know she didn't know to click the little ready for race thing. We're booping down. Boopity, there we go. So here you have it. It's based on the Buccaneer. It's a stretch hearse Buccaneer. And with either a really great prop or a dead guy in the back. Trying to... Wow! Check out the wheels over here. So we've both taken kind of non-standard cars. And we wiggle this through. As you see, the Lurcher has pretty good acceleration. It's not a bad car. I mean, you wouldn't want to try and race it against the fastest cars there are. But it is fun. I mean, yeah, you could. I was obviously willing to. I didn't know what she was showing up with. But yeah, she's a little far behind there, so we'll just squeak it through here just for style points. Just to show you can, it'll fit. Where is she? Is she coming? Hello? And Manana. Manana. Manana? Are you there? Oh! And she didn't land it right. Well, that happens. Well, we can take this nice and careful and just... Waiting for Emanana. Manana, manana, manana's enough for me. Yeah. All right, let's just hustle this through here. Kaboom. Not the greatest handling car in the world, but not horrible. Well, maybe kind of horrible. It's not the worst thing. It's not the Frankenstein. Where is she? Come on. Come on. Well, here she comes. Miss America. We got two laps going, so we're just gonna cruise on down here. Come on. Make me chase her. Come on. We want to see that car. Did she just go to hit me? Like, I sat there and waited for you. Ah, you're taking the long way around. Okay. You can do that. I did that at first, too, when I didn't know the track. Those roads at the side are just decorations. Let's land this. Kaboom. And once again, woo-wee! Scrapey, scrapey. Come on. Come on, mañana. Eh. Race with me. I want you to race with me. Come on. Angel, what is it with people in this game? Like, I'm waiting for you to catch up. I'm being that nice. Okay, now we're just gonna follow her here for a little bit. Gotta go from the. Do we let her win just because? Whenever I see lower ranked players, I always say, do they need wins to unlock something for their cars, you know? There you go. Alright, well, that was without incident. Come on, up the hill! Come on. You go this way. Just go around this way. There she goes! Congratulations, you've won the race! And you're probably totally confused. Not a little bit confused, just totally confused. And I would love to know what her actual taunt is. Virgo. You don't see the Virgo raced very often. I'm fairly certain you're better off with any of the stock, you know, rentals than a Virgo. But did she free mode out on me? I let her win, she free modes out. I don't understand. Let's do the time warp.
This is actually a pretty name.
What's actually pretty? Oh, there's. Now we're getting back into the lobby, and apparently things got weird. But that was all Manana.
Oh, this is cool.
She's in a Roosevelt of some nature. Roosevelt Valor? Alright, now this could be a race.
Open it.
Let's not freak her out.
Hold on.
Yo, what the fuck is that?
Okay.
Let's see what's going on here. We need another race. We need another race.
Oh, okay.
What is it?
Hold on. Oh my goodness.
I always do that. I have to do some of my own jobs at some point. That might be one way to get the Sanctus if you.
Do you see me?
Or if you do a
capture.
Okay. You make your own capture, you can put the Sanctus in it, but you can't do a race with it. Why, I don't know.
Okay. No, that's not.
Possibly because it's not a very fast bike.
Yeah.
Okay, well, fire up duel. Two laps of duel.
Wait, jump.
Come on, guys, I'm bringing the Frankenstein. They told me it was Frankenstein.
Thank you.
Well, they were wrong, weren't they? Here we are with the auto invite. Listening to people be random. I rep DGK. DGKS. Deeks. Alright, we got a level 153 here, so it's a little bit closer. At that point, pretty much everybody should know what they're doing. So they will run this one a little more flat out. Ready, and who's IREP Diggs? Well, that was unpleasant. Some kind of face paint dealio here. Maybe look at me for. Oh, jeepers. Thank you for getting into the Halloween spirit, but, again, why are we waiting this long? Everybody should be... There's two of us. Come on, hit the ready thing. This evens up on me today. Alright, what am I racing now? Oh, hey, a Dominator. That's, you know, one of, if not the, well, the fastest has really gone to the custom Saber Turbo, but not by much. And if you can drive a Dominator, you can dominate. But this is a tough track for the Dominator. There's a lot of turns, you have to be able to drift it around, or at least control your turning. Now, I haven't taken an easy car myself on this. This is another slippy, slidey car to a certain extent, but I don't know that it's as bad as the Dominator. Oh, gotta squeeze through here. Oh, I'm happy with myself that I made that. That was good. Pow, pow, pow. And he's not slipstreaming me anymore. What's... Yeah, all right. Taking that turn as fast as we can without going into the bushes. Carrying the momentum up to the jump. And what the heck happened to the Dominator? Are they just afraid of the Lurcher? Is it just too rare an item? Doesn't everybody want a hearse? I mean, you know, come on. Actually, I still haven't gotten to do the mission where you can steal a hearse from the motorcycle club missions, the biker missions. And oh, there you go. Well, that'll buy him some time. Especially if I don't make this jump because I'm going too slow. Come on. Can you go fast enough to make the jump? Ooh, that was more a matter of length than speed. You almost go off the cliff and still, where is the Dominator? I chose him behind me, so maybe he's coming up soon. Whee! Bang. Does it wanna turn? The Dominator is not dominating. What's he doing over there? He's going overhead. Wow, I've really... I don't want to, like, kill people here, you know? It's like, you don't want to DNF them on a two-lap race. I mean, that's just... Come on, Dominator. I want to go door handle the door handle with you. Can the Mustang beat a hearse? You know what I'm saying? This is... Kaboom! There we go. Wheel around here on my Halloween special that's not coming out till, I don't know, early November. But hopefully with much better sound quality. Hope this is actually working because I had moved it back a little bit. Adjusted the gain, put on the pop filter. But you really find this is really quiet and I go through like a 38 minute video and there's like nothing there. That'll be just great. Of course, that's how this video started out. Oh dear! Oh. Come on, flip and flip and rock-a-bye baby on the treetop. Come on. After all of that, I'm still in first. Here he comes! In the opposite direction? Was it? And he just blew up. Something bad happened there. This is now becoming one of those things where do I let him win? Or do I just tease him and then win at the end? I mean, yeah, she was driving a Virgo. I mean, you know, that's 10 out of 10 for style and minus several million for good racing. I mean, again, that's I'm doing the same thing. It's Halloween, so maybe that's what she's doing. And I say she going on the trust that that's, you know, it's actually a girl dressed as a girl. You don't see that a lot on Grand Theft Auto. I don't, you know, not that I've ever checked. All right, there, coming off the ramps, we can see... I rep Digix. I repair something. I don't know. Well, let's see. How close can we make it? I won. You didn't. Alrighty then. Yay! There I am. No taunt whatsoever because they refuse to fix that. Maybe when the Shotaro comes out or whatever new vehicle comes out, they'll patch that. Good game! There you go. I said good game. Does that mean you'll keep playing here? We'll do another... We can do over the bridge. I don't care. We can do over the bridge. If you let's stay in here so we don't lose him. Oh, he wants to do high flat. Either way, let's see which one goes. I outrank him. I probably have more job points, so that might be the tiebreaker. No, here we go. We got over the bridge. Let's custom vehicles. We'll turn off the custom vehicles here and try to make it fair. Okay. Let's see, let's click the auto invite in so you can get some more people. So that's his overall look. Wow, that's pretty aggressive. Now we have Verheiden and Esekemoidea. There's a funny story that goes on with Verheiden after a while, but we're waiting for Esekemoeda and he leaves. All right, so this is the three of us. Okay, let's do this thing. Cliffhanger. What do I want to do here? What do I want to do of these? I mean, the baddie's probably the fastest of what's available. I can't do a Kachu drag. The gargoyle's got to be the most Halloween-y, which I really should have changed it to orange, but at that point I felt like I was holding people up, you know. There's Raiden, there's IRF Digik. Now we're just waiting for it to kick. Gargoyle's not a bad bike. I like the gargoyle. I might actually get a gargoyle, because I do like the styling on it. It's got that Mad Maxiness to it, or, you know, hill climber, really. It's more of a hill climbing kind of thing. The physics behind chains on the road is completely, you know, it shouldn't even work at all here, but we can violate physics. Pop that wheelie, get that wheelie boost from the wheelie glitch that has to do everything, I think, with how the physics in this game works. Where down is a relative thing. All right, and apparently I rep Dick is apparently doesn't appreciate the fact that I almost let him win there. That was like, you know, which was as much for making me money as anything else. All right, these guys fight, and then we all go on the wall together like a bunch of puppies, and now we're trying to. Well, geek, this is very, very jumpy. Everyone bouncing into each other. If this were real bikes, we'd of course all be dead. Slipstream past. And back up into first. And just because I'll just hit you. I'll just keep hitting you. That's, don't need to make passes or anything like that. We'll just keep slamming into each other. Just keep hitting and hitting and. Now that's really where they beat me, because they hit me so that I had to miss the checkpoint, which is like, gang. Really? That's the way you gotta be. Alright, well at least we'll now have a more peaceful cruise than the over the bridge kind of thing. I do like this track. This is a nice track. It's turning into my favorite motorcycle track here. Some of the jumps are huge. I'm trying to think. I think I screwed this one up. I cut it too close. Yep, cut it too close. Woo! And then it falls backwards. You know, I was trying to use the gravity to my advantage. But somebody else messed up there too, so then we were okay. Still cut that almost too close. You're better going straight off without trying to cut the kern on that one, just so you can, or you're cutting the kern, the flurn. Just so you can land in the middle of the big blue thing and then, you know, be a little more safe. I don't know if you save any time cutting that anyway. You made a little. Right, he just hung on the track and I'm coming upon him fast. Barely make it into the bridge and he did. Into second place. Roombity, roombity, boopity, pippity, flappity, and Verheiden calls us all newbies. Because that's what you do when you win a race, you know. You're all newbies, I know what I'm doing, I'm Verheiden, and it's like a, that sets the tone, that's just great. Well, I'm at this point ready just to take second and be happy with it, because considering the stuff I had to overcome there, I think I did not bad. You know, missing a checkpoint because you get bounced out. And here we go. He's in Papa Wheelie mode. Whee! And then into the water. Goosh. I finished second. Get some modicum of money. Blah, 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 27.28. It's better than a poke in the eye with a sharp stick. There he is. Verheiden! So we hit the like. I always try to hit the like. Do duel. Oh yeah, let's do duel. Oh, he free modes out on me. And what happens? What did we get? I don't even remember what we got on this. Was it a redo of duel? Oh no, I remember what happened. Yep, yep, wait and see this. So we're waiting. And we're waiting. We're waiting. And pretty soon, you'll see what race we got. Means I guess we could just comment here on the unified biker look of these people who are really into being the biker gang. They got the vest on vest sort of thing, all kinds of tattoos, headband going. He's got the helmet. They probably have all kinds of conversations about helmets versus no helmets. I had a friend who was adamant that he was safer without a helmet because he could see better what's going on. And then we have this happen. Where I just dumped out. I don't know what happened there. And then Verheiden shoots me in this corner. For no reason whatsoever. Now I'm stuck on the beach. And as I recall, I was completely ticked off. Just so you know, Verheiden, this is all going on YouTube. So, people will see, if you're with Verheiden, that's what you get. Oddly enough, this goes back and forth for a little while, and I ended up friending him. You know, it's a funny kind of thing. And there's a protracted discussion of, you know, me being a YouTube dreamer with only 400 plus subs, you know. I was ticked. I don't even know why I was so ticked. I must have been just tired. You know, here I am. I'm trying to be nice, and people just shoot you in the head and call you names.
Going to Rockford Plaza is always such a bloody hassle, but I do
not. I should have listened in on that conversation. That looked like it was like some kind of rare event, but I was annoyed. Now I'm just like, well, where do I even go now? Where can I go to even get a bike where my mechanic can get to me? I rested, not even typing right. He called... Can't even type. Look at this. I'm a completely... Ben shoots me in the head. Ben shoots me for no reason. When we get out. And there goes our ripped dick. There you go. Somehow he got stuck here too. Nice. Now I'm stuck on the beach. But I don't care. I'm stuck on the beach with no vehicle. Me! I won the race. They're all noobs. Again, this is, you know, these is a kids. Okay, so I'm assuming Verheiden is probably English, not his primary language, but that means he can speak German and English, which is like a hell of a lot more than I can do. I can barely speak English sometimes, I think. Get my mix all talked up sometimes. Now, Sergeant Morningwood had some pretty good things going on there. I'm 23! I'm almost twice your age. Now, this is an interesting conversation right here. Shut up, a YouTube dreamer, yeah. You play to be PewDiePie? So Bass, you're like 40? And you play GTA 5? And they think that's hilarious. 45 years old. In case you're wondering, yes, I'm 45 years old. And I'm talking into my personal 45th birthday present here. Admittedly, yeah, I'm a YouTube dreamer. I don't expect really to be like, you know, a multi-millionaire at any point here. Wouldn't turn it down. Don't you have a life, dude? Hey, do you plan on quitting games when you're getting older? Hi, grandfather. Probably. No, people, let me let you in on a little bit of wisdom from Chuck Yeager, okay? Chuck Yeager said that basically when you get older, you still want to do all the things you want to do. He didn't want to not fly airplanes just because he was getting older. And he flew jets into his 80s, I think. And he said, when I can't fly jets, I'll fly ultralights. And when I can't fly ultralights, I'll read about stuff. It's like just no different than when he couldn't, when he said one day when he can't, he's too old to hike all the way up to his favorite fishing spot, he'll fish somewhere closer by. You do what you can, and if you can't do it, you do the next best thing. And video games. I should be able to do this into my hundreds here, as long as I, Now somehow, this appealed to him here. And he's like, you know what? You have 425 subs. Good luck, man. Hey, thanks much. And we became friendly. And he wanted me to, you know, add him back. It would be, you know, it's a weird thing. You got this whole guy thing where, you know, guys abuse each other and then become friends. I've seen it before, you know. Well, nothing's impossible, mate, so good luck. You give people a little bit of good attitude as opposed to a bad attitude back. Everyone's basically a good person. Did you get married? Oh, yeah, married, couple of kids, whole nine yards. Day job, the whole nine yards. That's what I put, yeah, and I do. That's why I can't, you know, I can't rock out as many videos as perhaps some people can, because why? I've got a day job, you got the whole family thing going. I'm off today, it's Friday, and I'm trying to crank a whole bunch of stuff out. I got 4 videos uploading while I'm recording this that I've been working on during the week. And this is the truth, because the reason I do these videos, folks, is because I like it. I do like making videos. I do like giving opinions. You know, I get 5 hits. I'm like, hey, 5 people watched my video. That's kind of cool. You know, I forget who said it. I could look this up, you know, when I'm in a more Googleable frame. And we'll be able to put that up on here somewhere. But it doesn't matter the size of your audience. It matters that they're listening. And, you know, It does, yeah, if I didn't like doing this, I wouldn't do it. You know, it's... That's the truth, you know. There's, you know, I don't try to let kind of what's popular at the time dictate what I'm driving at here. You know, I did for a little while. I really was pushing for a little while. I mean, you know, I was playing Fallout 4 probably a lot longer than I actually was into. I finally burned out on that. I think the last time I actually... Now, here's the interesting thing. I have got Fallout 4 videos scheduled through the end of the year. We've got lots of them. But I need to take a break from it. And that's what I've done. I haven't really played since July 4th. My character is still sitting there and...
Hey, do you guys have mics?
At this point, I didn't have a mic. I think, yeah. I think it was dead at that point. And hey, we have a jet coming in. And oddly enough, I'm just starting to get a little bit of a hankering for it to continue things onward there. But my character over there is...
Who's Yeti?
Who's Yeti? No, that's my mic. Name of the new mic. There was some confusion there. Comment in the description if you think the Yeti is giving me a better sound.
Oh, yeah, not my... I'm retarded.
Oh. No. It's just a misunderstanding.
Can I join?
And I did add the guy. We're buds now. You know, I haven't seen him yet. But we will see the return of Verheiden. If I'm even... Comment in the description for Haydn if I'm saying that right.
If you guys are doing races, invite me, because I need to do some, like, objectives and shit.
Cool enough. And we're almost at the end here, folks. But lately, I tell you what, I haven't even been playing Team Fortress 2. I haven't had much of a chance. There's certain things that drive what games I'm going to be playing. Real life is a big one. You know, what time do I have available?
I'll say it again.
Stop it. You don't have to say it again. What time do I have available? What things do I want to do?
Hey, Verheiden, want to do some races? If that's how you pronounce your name.
Verheiden? You say Verheiden, and I say Verheiden. Verheiden, Verheiden. And now the video's looping around again. So on that note, ladies and gentlemen, this is the Black Knight wishing you a happy Halloween several days after Halloween's over. This is the Black Knight. Have a great night.